Hi, Graham.
Afternoon.
Can I start with some team news, please?
We've got Bursan back in the group. Apart from that, we're pretty much as we were. Everybody's okay, sort of recovering from the game, so just Bursan, so that's good news for us.
Yeah, obviously a welcome addition. He's an important player, isn't he?
He is, yeah. I mean, we'll decide whether he's ready to start. Probably he's been a bit in and out of training for the last couple of weeks, so probably closer to the bench, but you know, we'll see. But yeah, it's great to have him in the group.
Leroy got some minutes at Ipswich Town. Good to see him back. Is he okay?
Yeah, he's okay. He's had a sort of a feeling in his knee, so we'll just check that over the next sort of couple of days. But hopefully he'll be okay.
He doesn't seem to have had much luck this season, Leroy, does he?
No, we've struggled to keep him on the pitch. It's fair to say. He's been great around the place, great with the group. And when he's been on the pitch, he's influenced and helped us, but probably not as much as he would like or we would like.
His contract's up in the summer. Is it possible we won't see him again in a Swan shirt, or is that not the situation?
No, that's not the situation. We'll take all those decisions, the majority of those decisions, at the end of the season when all the games are finished and we have a chance to sit down and talk in a proper way. Like I said before, the players have a say in what they do. It's their lives as well, so we have to take everything and make our decisions to go forward and try and improve.
How's Martin Olsen? I know at one point there was some talk of him trying to get back before the season ended. Is there any hope for that, or is it too soon?
I think it will be too soon. He's making progress and he's working hard, but I think realistically he's been out too long to be sort of rushed back into first team action before next season.
After you lost at QPR, you said that was that for the playoffs. Now, not so sure.
Well, it just shows you that the Championship is unpredictable and can throw up results. And we've got we're a very big outside chance. I think it's fair to say mathematically. While you still have a chance in going into the last week, you can see why it's a conversation, but realistically we have to win all our games, as simple as that, and then even then that might not be enough, like I said, after the game. But again, it's the Championship, this stage of the season, funny results happen and strange things, so we need to just focus on ourselves, focus on the next game, which is Hull City, and try and win that.
Have you looked at the there's quite a few teams still in it, aren't there, which is part of the problem, I guess, from your point of view. But have you looked at everybody else's fixtures and had a think about, you know, who might drop points where, that sort of thing?
No, because like I said, it's when you're in our position, it doesn't really matter what the other teams do if we don't get our points. So our focus is it's quite simple, it's quite clear. We have to win. We have to win our games. Focus on Saturday. Focus on the next match. And if we can win that, great. We move on to the next one and we try again.
You've hit form at just the right time, though, haven't you? Five wins in sixth, at the business end of the season?
Well, I think we've improved as the season's gone on. I think that's what we've done. And I think over the last 10 games after the last international break, I think our performances have got better and better. Like I said, we've had good performances where we haven't got results. But over the course of that time, I think we have improved and taken another step forward. So it's just great for us to be involved still in the last week. Great for the players, great for the supporters. Hopefully I'm sure the weather's going to be too favourable tomorrow, but hopefully it's a good atmosphere and we can enjoy the challenge of trying to win.
If you could get three more wins, it's a big if, a lot of work to do, but if you could do that, 71 points, do you think that will be competitive in terms of sixth place?
It'll be competitive, but again, your guess is as good as mine as to whether it's going to be enough. It's our position. You don't worry about that. You just worry about trying to get the 71, and how you do that is to focus on the next game, which is again Hull City. We have to try and win that game, and then just take the challenge up. It's exciting. I think it's really exciting. We'll see.
Are you contemplating the prospect of the playoffs, though? You know, in terms of your planning for training and that sort of thing. You know, it could be that everybody's on holiday at the end of next week. It could be that the season is, you know, there's 2 or 3 weeks left of it.
I think everybody that's in professional football, whilst there's still a mathematical chance that you can achieve something, you have to have a plan around that. until it's no longer the case. But the main plan is to try to focus on and to concentrate on the next match, and then, like I said, then we'll see.
How big an achievement would it be to reach the playoffs this season, your first season, given everything that we've talked about all season long about the readjustment following relegation?
Yeah, I mean, it would be, I think it'd be amazing, but we're quite some way off, and you can talk and dream and think, and the reality of it is not going to get you anywhere. It's not going to get you points. We have to try, and our target is to try to get 71 points. And to do that, we have to win on Saturday. And then if we can win on Saturday, then we carry forward. And you know, I think that's the only way to approach this period, to take the challenge up, to be really, really excited about it. It's nice to go into the last week still having something to play for. And hopefully the supporters and the players can enjoy a positive day tomorrow.
Hull were in the mix themselves, weren't they, not long ago, but they've had a little run of defeat, which has ended their hopes. Now I think the manager is talking about giving other players a chance and maybe leaving some players out. What sort of challenge will they present, do you think?
I think they'll pose a really strong challenge, a really tough challenge. They've got some really good attacking players. Both wide men are probably, as a combination, are as good as they are in the league. I think Nigel's done a really, really good job there, because they were tipped from the so-called experts to struggle and to be sort of top half and fighting for the playoffs. And the football they play is really, really good. So whichever team plays, whoever they play, and it's up to Nigel to decide. I'm sure they'll be ready and they'll be wanting to finish off the season as strong as possible, because they want that momentum going into next. And if they're giving players a chance, then they're keen to show what they can do. So it's a championship. It's nothing's easy.
You lost up there, didn't you? But it was one of those games where you may very well have come away with something, ended up with nothing.
Yeah, I mean, we played quite well in patches, but didn't control things as well as we maybe could, and the game sort of went away from us, really, where we felt that we were in decent control. But that just goes to show how strong they are in terms of they don't need to do too much to score and to create a goal. Like I said, their attacking players, certainly the transition as well, are really, really dangerous. Running power is incredible from Bowen. And so we know it's going to be a tough game, that's for sure.
When you look back across the season, there's quite a number of games where you've been in winning positions or you've played some really good football, perhaps controlled games, not got the result at the end. I've heard a lot of people say it in the last couple of weeks, if only we'd won at Rotherham, for example. West Brom recently, I know it ended up 3-0, but you controlled that game for long periods, and there's 5 or 6 more examples of that, aren't there? Is there a sense, I've heard a lot of fans saying it, you know, it's going to be what might have been, could be what might have been at the end of the season. Do you see that?
I think you can see it however you want to see it. I think what we've been through is a process. I think if anybody said that to deal with the relegation of the Premier League and all that comes with that, from in terms of turbulence, in terms of players coming or going, not knowing, and the negativity surrounding it, and then to the use of sort of young players. I think we're, in terms of under 23s, young for the not just the Championship but the Football League, just even as ourselves, as speaking personally, this time last year I'm in another country trying to win games in another country, another competition. So to come here and have a 4-week pre-season to try to find out, to create an atmosphere, an environment where people think there's an opportunity to play for Swansea City, and then at the same time try and get results in a really competitive league, I think, and at the same time developing a playing style, I think it's, you can always look back with regrets, but I think that's part of the process of getting to where you want to get to. That's how I see it. Unfortunately, I wasn't good enough to be able to come in on day one and say, this is the team, this is how we play, bang up away we go. But I'm not sure that would have helped us anyway.
Do you think, given all that, do you think next year you'll be in a better position to, assuming you're still in the Championship, to have a go at winning promotion?
But I think time was always, you should improve. That's how it is. That's what the job is. And the more you know, the more mistakes you've made, the more learning you've had, the more you've tried things and failed, the more you know, you're in a better place to make, you know, decisions, and then hopefully as a group, as a team, you can improve. That's how I've sort of worked in my previous job, and we got success doing that, and I'd like to continue it, you know, here. There's no magic formula. You just have to, in any profession, try your best. If it works well, good. If it doesn't, what can you learn from that, and then move forward.
Are you planning for next season already, Graham? Whatever, you still don't know what division you'll be in at this point. Are you already putting things in place for next year at this point?
Yeah, it's planning and talking, and like you say, it's quite still a need to be flexible and a need to adapt to situations. Like you say, we don't necessarily know a lot of things. But the main thing is to focus on finishing this season. I think if this group of players can end up with 71 points, regardless of what that means, I think that's a huge effort for them. And, you know, that's our focus at the moment, to try and finish off the season strongly as we can, with as many points as we can.
Any news on anybody's contract?
Please. Nope. Nothing. Sorry, Gareth.
As you were, everything's going to be at the end, is it?
At this stage, yeah. Nothing to announce.
Alan Curtis said this week that what really matters, regardless of all the speculation about the players, what really matters is that you'll be here next year. Nice for you to hear, I imagine.
Well, from somebody that I respect enormously, from Alan, of course. Like I said before, he's a special person. Anybody that's met Alan will know what I mean, especially to this club. But he's a good guy. He's a good human being. So that's nice to hear, of course.
You're not going to let him down, are you, and disappear off anywhere?
No. I'll have a coffee with him over the summer, and we'll have a chat and reflect and see how we can move forward. It's great that he's still involved in the club, and I look forward to working with him.
Great stuff. Thank you.
Cheers.